Hi guys, I'm Rahul and welcome back to Fwrapper Aqua. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do consider subscribing. We regularly make videos on discus keeping, planted tanks and marine tanks, and a lot of tips and tricks about the hobby. So, and don't forget to hit the bell icon, because a lot of you guys don't hit the bell icon, so you guys don't get notified when we post videos. So please don't forget to hit the bell icon. So let's get started with this video then. Grindal worms, that's what this video is all about, and how to start off with grindal worms culture and what and all things you need to do to start this off. So previous week I had made a video on micro worms culture after I purchased the starter kit from microworms.in. So I had also picked up grindal worms culture from that website. So this video is about the whole process of the grindal worms culture. I'm also going to be leaving the link of their website in this video's description. So please do have a look at their website. They have a lot of other products which you guys can check out. And so let's get started with this video, and stay tuned and see you on the other side. This video, if you've seen the previous video, we have unboxed what I received from microworms in .in. This is video we're going to be talking about culturing or propagating grindal worms. So for that, so you need to see the previous video. I'll leave the link on top where what and all came with this the starter kit. So they came with this one starter kit, and then there is some dog food which is required for them to grow. So now what we need to do additionally is that you'll need a plastic box, size of a bread box. It's not food grade and all, you can just pick it up from any normal plastic or supermarkets. These are available. It's maybe about 6 to 8 inches, I think. So this is not airtight, so you don't need to make holes and stuff. So you need this, you need some water,
bubble butter.
So if you've seen the previous video, we got the I picked up some cocoa pit from microworms.in. we're going to be using one cube or cake, whatever you can call it, from this. So put this inside, and then fill water and wait for it till it expands. Take some time, and this whole thing will break down. Now you can see that it's expanding, and it will slowly break down. You can see that that small block has become so tall. So now it has absorbed all the water what I poured. Now you just need to break this down. Need to add some more water. So basically you need to leave it for some time so it kind of breaks down completely, and all the water, see, all this pieces still needs to get water inside. And spread it across your container and let it be there for some time. If you guys feel that you don't want to use your hand directly, you can use your gloves, but it's not harmful, so it's okay. So basically this is the same cocoa pit that people use in gardening, so it's more fun to do gardening when you do it with your own hands. But there are people who like to use gloves, so you can use gloves also.
now this is actually completely, it has absorbed the water and all that. To check consistency, you just take a lump and try and make a ball. So it should remain like a thick ball. It shouldn't be too much of water is also not good. So it should stay like this. You can see that there's a lump. So it should remain like that. So too much of water is not needed. You just have that small dampness and that small moisture kind of a feel that you know when you do it with your hands. So that's why you need to do it with your hands. You cannot make that out and you use a gloves. So this is pretty okay. You spread it out equally. So now this is ready. So it's time to introduce the grindleworm culture into our startup. You guys can see the worms. They're all moving. Creepy. So this we're going to dump into our cocopit box. You can see there are some stuck to the side of the container, so we'll use little water and put them into this. So there's some still left in the corners, so we'll pour some water and take it out. See, all the worms have got, most of it has got collected in the bottom. So now we'll pour it into our. Don't use too much water because again then the cocopit will get a little more loose. So let's not use too much of water. There's some more left, so I'm just trying to collect them all in the sides, on the sides. Got most of it. So now we need to spread this out. This is actually dog food which is put in the container which the grindle worms came in. So now anyway these guys will feed on it, so I'm gonna be just pushing it inside so they can feed on it. Okay. Mistake, you should not push it inside, you should leave it outside. Only then the worms will come out. So one here and one here. So this is the food which came with the starter kit. So I put it in two places. So now we need to let it be for about 10 to 15 days till this whole culture gets completely established. You can see the worms actually moving around. So now I've placed the two, I've not added any food, fresh food they've given. In the packet, this is some dog food, but I am not adding it now because there's already food inside. So generally it's ideally to be fed once in 2 days. If it's not eaten, it has to be removed, otherwise it kind of forms cotton kind of fungus, is what Arun told me. So this is just put in today, so it's already been consumed a little bit. So now after some time since they're spread across, they'll all come to the food in some time. So I will take a shot of that. The only thing we need to take care is that food shouldn't be left unattended for very long. If you do that, what happens? That fungus will form and then the whole culture might crash. So we need to be very careful about that. So I will take another shot after 6 to 8 hours and then let's see what happens. So as what I've heard from Arun, all of them will be here on the food. So let's hope it's there. Yep. So I'll use the lid and close it. Store it in a place, dry, cool place, away from ants. Ants can be bad for these guys, so if you have ants in your place, you need to look at it, keeping it in some place where the ants cannot reach it. So be careful. So let's take a shot after about 6 to 8 hours and see what has happened. So this is day 2 after we started the this particular harvest, and you can see the food which we had put yesterday has been completely consumed. So these are all the worms which are there in the box. These are all accumulated on the food. It's pretty cool, and the worms are all over the place actually. So the worms are creepy.
This is day 4 after I've started this culture. I need to add some of food, I guess.
So this is the Grindal Worm culture which has been running for some time. So you can see there's quite a lot of worms which are generated. So basically I use this kind of a small thin piece of acrylic and place it on top of food, that is your pedigree, the dog food what we fed them. So as you can see, I've kept this piece here, and there's a lot of them stuck to the acrylic piece. You see, it's a live worm, so just stuck to that. So we need to wipe this out into a plate and then try and feed this to my discus. Let's do that. So this is what I've collected. So I'm putting this back onto where it was. Should be good for later. So I'm just going to wash this out and then we'll feed them.
Look, actually once you take them into this container from the culture box. So this is like fresh worms. So I've washed them out into, like you can see, it settles down. So the top water is pretty clear. So you can actually throw out this water till a certain level and fill in fresh water and wash it out 2 times. And yeah, and then this can be fed to the babies or to your big fishes. They look big, but they're not that big actually. They're pretty small. Once they go into the fish tank, they're pretty small. But it's good.
Yeah. I don't know if you can see, there's quite a lot of them inside. So you can see that they slowly started taking the food, that is the Grindal Worms, and they're slowly eating it. And they all seem to like it. It's good. Some of the guys are putting on some size. So that's good. If they are happy, I'm happy. So these Grindal Worms actually don't float in the water, so they go down. So that's why they are pricking from the bottom. So they actually, like you saw earlier, no? They, as soon as you put them in water, they settle to the bottom. So that's how these guys are actually now going in search of them and eating them. It's nice.
So I fed some to my babies, they love it. So let's feed these to my big ones and see how they guys like it. Yeah. Better to switch off the filter if you have a filter running. These guys are taking time, but slowly they are finding it. Yeah, like the Alankar there has found some. Yeah, so they take some time and yeah, you can see this guy getting it. Yeah. So these guys just need to get used to the food because I'm feeding for them for the first time. Yeah, they'll eventually get it all. Okay, that's some live food for you guys. So hope you guys like this video. If you did, give us a big thumbs up and like and share our videos, and do leave in your comments and tell us what you guys think about this video. And like I said in the beginning of this video, if you guys like the product and if you guys want more stuff, you can definitely visit microworms.in. The link's there in this video's description, so do check out their website. And like I always say, this hobby is really fun, guys, if you do it the right way. Cheers. Love you all. Bye-bye.